Hey guys, welcome to this week's Kids Church Online. Oh wait, what happened? I think the lights have gone out. Wait, no, it's okay. No, we're back again. Sorry, I think our lights gave us a bit of a problem there for a moment. It's super important that we stay connected, because with that power, then everything can work as it should. In fact, being a devoted disciple is pretty much the same. We have to stay connected with our walk with Jesus every single day. Today in this lesson, we'll look at an example of two disciples who did that really well. We'll look at James of Alphaeus, and we'll look at Judas, also known as Jude, or Thaddeus. This is not to be confused with Judas, who then betrayed Jesus later on. This is a completely different guy. These two guys set out this example really well, and that's exactly what we're going to look at today. So kids, are you guys ready? Are you guys ready to learn what it looks like to be a committed and connected, devoted disciple of Jesus? Well, if you are, make sure you get your dance moves ready as we're going into praise and worship right after this. Here we go.
Hello, moms and dads. I know you sneakily watch these videos during the week as well, because they're so good and there's so many good things to learn. But I want to tell you a Bible story today. In fact, I love the way that Jesus often tells Bible stories, because he uses different things that we know in our lives at times that we can use. Sometimes he would talk about athletes and how well they run and how we should be running races. And the Bible talks about soldiers at times and how do we need to be good soldiers. But not everybody knows about athletics and sports, and not everybody knows about being a soldier and fighting in a battle and in a war. But there's one analogy, there's one picture that Jesus uses that I think we can all understand. And it's the time he talks in John chapter 15 about vines, about trees, about when you're out in the garden and you see your beautiful trees growing and the branches and the leaves. He uses that, which is something we can all understand. And so I brought with me today a kind of a plant that has some lovely, thin, narrow leaves and branches kind of that we will look at and talk about today. But Jesus was talking to his disciples and to those that were listening, and he was saying to them, we are pretty much like this tree in so many ways. And the branches that grow off, the leaves that grow off, the life that grows off of it is like our lives. But it all needs to start somewhere. It needs a main vine. It needs a starting place. It starts at the roots, but then there's a trunk that often grows, or a main part of a tree that grows. And Jesus says to us, He will be that main part. He will be the main part of the tree where all the life comes from, where all the nutrients that the tree needs to get to survive and to produce fruit. I will be that, and you will be like the branch. But sometimes we don't live our lives like that. We think that we can live our lives on our own. And then the Bible actually uses another picture, and it says when we do that, we're like dead wood. We won't produce anything. And that's why it's so important that we stay connected to the main part of the tree. We stay connected to Jesus. How do we stay connected? We read our Bible, we pray, we come to church, we engage with the things that God asks us to be involved in. And then He also says something else about the tree, because some trees grow fruit. And we know that Jesus says sometimes as a Christian, in fact, not sometimes, all the time, we need to be showing good fruit. And there's lots of fruit that we can be showing. But so many times I've seen Christians, or let's call them as Jesus calls them in the story, I see branches trying to produce fruit so hard that they forget to stay connected to the main part. And they would be like a branch with an arm out, and they would try to push out the fruit, and they would use all their energy, and they're trying to produce fruit, and then little things happen, some little things go, but nothing really, really grows. But what Jesus says to us, I will make sure the fruit grows. Put all your energy, put all your effort in staying connected. Some Bibles use the word remain in me, stay connected in me. The most often ones, and you might have heard your parents use it, or when you've heard it preached in a church somewhere, it says abide in me, because you can do nothing. You can produce no fruit when you're not connected to me. So instead of at times thinking, well, I've got to try and be good, or I've got to try and be kind, and I've got to try and be gentle, try and have self-control, you can only do so much. The Bible says you can't do this on your own. That's why Jesus says, be like the branch, and the focus of the branch is stay connected. Read your Bible, pray, have a relationship with God, and I'll tell you what will happen. When you focus on that, you'll look out, and from time to time, you will just see the fruit popping out of you. You will start speaking differently, living differently, behaving differently. Kindness will just appear. Love will just appear. Gentleness will just appear. Self-control, and all of those things will appear because you're focusing on the main thing. Remain in me. I'm the vine, Jesus says. You are the branch. Stay connected, and automatically the fruit will come. Don't spend all your effort trying to push out fruit, and don't stay connected, because the life won't flow through you. Stay connected. Jesus says, I will be that for you, and you can do nothing on your own. What a great story. What a great reminder. And He says to us, don't be like dead wood. Produce some fruit. Be a plant. Be a person that people would want to come to, get life from, and see life in. And the only way you can do that is when you stay rooted, stay connected to the vine. God bless you, and I can't wait to see you again soon.
Hey kids, welcome to activity time. So I'm so excited for today. We have Sean and Judy, who will be competing against one another to build the strongest bridge. Wait for it, dum dum dum, using toothpicks and marshmallows. So, the aim of this activity is to build a bridge that is strong enough, sturdy, and will hold up for at least 30 seconds, strong enough so that when I push these tiny cars across, it will go over smoothly. So, kids, you are welcome to try this activity at home. But remember, as devoted disciples of Christ, we need to honor our homes. So when you make a mess, please do clean up after yourselves. So what you'll need for this activity is your bag of marshmallows, okay? then your toothpicks, you can use the tiny ones or the medium-sized ones, all right? And just be careful with those toothpicks as well, kids. All right, and then you also need a lovely table to build your bridge as well. Okay, we have here, right here. Awesome, so I'm ready. Judy and Sean, are you guys ready? Okay, well, the clock starts now. On your marks, get set, go. Kids, their time is up. Wow, what wonderful, beautiful creations you guys have made. Beautiful, okay, wonderful. So it's not about just how well connected and sturdy and strong this bridge is, but it's also just how tough it is when I push the car across. Let's see what happens. What do you think, kids? Okay, I'm gonna try and see. First, I'm going to test Sean's. Let's see. Okay. Was better. Well done, Sean. He almost made it across. Well done. Let's test Judy's bridge. Okay. Let's see. All right. Let's try again. Well, what do you think?
It made it across.
It sort of made it across. Okay, so I've got to make this decision to judge which bridge was more sturdy. And I'm sorry, kids, I'm going to have to announce the win. And I think I'm going to give this to Sean. So well done, Sean. Your bridge was the sturdiest and the car did go almost over. So well done. Awesome. Thank you so much, Judy and Sean, for joining us for this activity today.
Hey kids, be encouraged to stay devoted and connected to Jesus, who is faithful to connect with us because he loves us so, so very much. What I'd like you to do at home when you hear this wonderful verse is to pause, take a moment, and let this beautiful verse just sink into your heart. You want to hear it? Here it goes. Jesus says, "I am the vine, you are the branches. Those who remain in me and I in them will produce much fruit. For apart from me, you can do nothing." John 15, verse 5. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we just want to thank you for loving us so much. And you wanted to stay connected to us, that you sent your Son, Jesus, to take our place on the cross and die for us, for all of our sins. We love you so very much, and we so want to be connected with you. We love you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Yeah.
So guys, I hope you enjoyed today's lesson. I hope you grabbed something out of it, out of looking at the life of Judas and James. These two disciples who stayed connected to Jesus and really showed us an example of what a devoted disciple looks like. So my encouragement to you then, guys, is to stay connected to Jesus, just like we saw these two disciples do. How they stayed connected allowed them to become who God created them to be, and it gave them the power then to shine His love like He created them to. In the same way, we as well have to stay connected to Jesus so that we could do what He created for us to do. So I look forward to seeing you guys next time, and make sure you tune in next week. Cheers.
We would love to hear from you, so please write to us and share with us any personal testimonies, what you learned about the lesson, and those beautiful drawings of each Bible story lesson. Send this to our email at kids@harvest.co.za. Also, check out our Harvest Kids Facebook page for any activity worksheets and downloads. We would also love for you to send a video of your best praise and worship dance moves to our Facebook page as well.